you've been in this science, and you've been at the cutting edge of the science for decades now.
Yeah.
So why has it exceeded your expectations?
Several tools came upon us which were unexpected. CRISPR is absolutely one of them. So just to go back a little bit to explain what CRISPR is a bacterial system by which you can make very specific alterations in the genome, which you couldn't do before. That technology, I would say, is groundbreaking and it really shook our worlds because I hadn't expected it.
Because in principle, you can now customize a human being.
In principle, you can customize the genomes in as I said, in small ways. People say, we're going to make new human beings that are, customizable to the nth degree, blue eyes, taller, whatever, et cetera. Those are almost impossible things to do. And that's because most of those traits are encoded not by one, but by hundreds, if not thousands of genes. That's puts a natural limit because with CRISPR, you can only go so far. So that's one thing that happened. The second thing that's happening very, very quickly is we're making synthetic genomes that are longer and longer and longer. Now, if you make a synthetic genome that's longer and longer and longer, very soon you're going to get to a place where you can put a really, really long piece of an entirely chemically synthesized piece of DNA. You don't need CRISPR for that. You can basically write a code. I hadn't expected the speed at which that's happened either. So now you can go up to thousands, tens of thousands. Very soon we'll be able to go up to millions of completely freshly written code, just like you would type into a computer. Last piece, or last two pieces. So I talked about CRISPR.
Yep.
I talked about synthetic genomes. Mm-hmm. Number three is we are now doing more and more bionic things. I talked about electrodes, so we're doing bionic things. We're extending our hands, our brains, using bionics. And where bionics comes in, of course, AI comes in. The minute you have bionics, you have AI, because artificial intelligence, in principle, allows you to do very much superior bionics.
So we can optimize a prosthetic leg,
for instance,
to work more effectively real one.
That's right. And we can optimize potentially a prosthetic electrical device that would sit on your brain to work much, much more effectively because there's a learning algorithm inside it, which wasn't there before. And I said there were four things. The fourth has been around for a while, but it's been cloning. So Dolly the sheep, it's moved along in time, and now all of a sudden we're cloning lower animals like sheep much, much more effectively. So what I'm trying to say is now combine all of these four pieces. These pieces are sort of sitting right now in different silos. But imagine a combination of all four of these, or some combination of these three things applied to a real human. And that's what I mean by the new human. That's the speed at which I had not expected these four pieces to come together. Again, to name them, CRISPR, synthetic biology, prosthetic biology with AI, and cloning of individuals. That's what is moving, this nexus has been moving faster than I had expected.